Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Skyrim. And we're ready. Well.
Blessings of Mara upon you.
Wait, what do I gotta do? I don't remember. Speak. Oh, I gotta wait for, Okay, I'm gonna read this while I wait. I was just gonna stop time. Okay. Judged upon the evidence of their interest in worldly matters, a central belief in the active participation of the deities in mundane matters can be challenged by the reference to apparent apathy and indifference on the part of gods during times of plague and or famine, from intervention in legendary quests to manifestations in common daily life. No pattern for the gods of Temera activates is rarely perceived. The concerns of gods in many ways may seem unrelated or at best unconcerned with the daily trials of the mortal realm. The expectations do exist, however. Many historical records and legends point to the direct invention of one or more gods at a time of great need. Many heroic tales recount blessings of the divinity bestowed upon heroic figures who worked or quested for the good of a deity or a deity temple. Some of the more powerful artifacts in the known world were originally bestowed upon their owners through such rewards, and it has also been reported that priests of high ranking in their temples may on occasion call upon their deity for blessings or help in times of need. The exact nature of such contact and blessing bestowed is given to much speculation, as the temples hold such associations secret and holy. This direct contact gives weight to the belief that the gods are aware of the mortal realm. In many circumstances, however, these same gods will do nothing in the face of suffering and death, seeming to feel no need to interfere. It is thus possible to conclude that we, as mortals, may not be capable of understanding more than a small fraction of reasoning and logic such being used. One defining characteristic of all gods and goddesses is their interest in worship and deeds. Deeds in the form of holy quests are just one of the many things that bring the attention of a deity. Deeds in everyday life, by conforming to statutes and obligations of individuals, temples are commonly supposed to please a deity. Performance of ceremony in a temple may also bring a deity attention. Ceremonies vary according to the individual deity. The results are not always apparent, but sacrifice and offerings are usually required to have any hope of gaining a deity's attention. While direct intervention is daily temple life has been recorded, the exact nature of the presence of a god is in daily mundane life is a subject of controversy. A traditional saying of the Wood Elves is that one man's miracle is another man's accident. While some gods are believed to take an active part of daily life, others are well known for their lack of interest in temporal affairs. Holy cow, how many? Okay, I'm almost done. It has been theorized that gods do in fact gain strength from such things as worship through praise, sacrifice, and indeed. It may even be theorized... Theorized that the number of worshippers a given deity has been reflecting on his overall position among the other gods. This is my own conjecture, garnished from the apparent ability of the larger temple to obtain blessings and assistance from their god with greater ease than smaller religious institutions. I just realized my wife has to walk all the way from White Rock. Nah, she'll take a carriage. There are reports of the existence of spirits in our world that have the same capability to use the actions and deeds of a mortal to strengthen themselves as do the gods. The understanding of the exact nature of such creatures would allow us to understand with more clarity the connection between a deity and a deity's worshipper. The implication of existence of such spirit leads to speculation, and that these spirits may even be capable of raising themselves to the level of god or goddess. Matsu of the Imperial Cemetery has suggested that these spirits may be the remains of gods and goddesses who, through time, lost all or most of their following, reverting to their earliest, most basic form. practitioners of the old ways say that these are no gods, just greater and lesser spirits. Perhaps it is possible for all three theories to be true. And that was for 5 hours. Anyways, wait. So, am I allowed to sleep in your bed? No. That's fine. I will sit.
How may I help myself?
You can get out of my way. Thank you.
Congratulations on your win. So happy for both of
you. I'm gonna sit down and wait. So 5 be 19. Do I not have friends? Oh, you're my friend.
Congratulations on your wedding. I'm so happy for both of you.
I just realized this is a day without my child. That's fine. Okay.
Congratulations on my wedding. I'm so happy for both of you.
Thank you.
It's our wedding day. I feel like all of Skyrim is focused on just the two of us. Congratulations on my wedding.
Okay, Lydia.
It's our wedding day. I feel like all of Skyrim is focused on just the two of us.
Do I have two friends?
I'm so happy for both of you. It's our wedding day.
Okay, let's get this going so they can stop reading.
May you return to benevolence and safety.
Congratulations on your wedding. I'm so happy for both of you. It's our wedding day. I feel like all of Skyrim is focused on just the two of us. Congratulations on your wedding.
Please.
How may I help you? May you return to her benevolence and
safety. Oh my, please.
It's our wedding day. I feel like all of Skyrim is focused on just the two of us. Congratulations on your wedding. It's our wedding day. I feel like all of Skyrim is focused on just the two of us.
Can you please hurry up? These two won't stop repeating the same thing.
Congratulations.
Oh my god.
I'm so happy for both of you.
Please, hurry up. Hurry up. Please, 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 please.
May you return to her benevolence and safety.
You have to put on the necklace. Is that what I have to do?
Congratulations on your wedding.
May you return to her.
Please, just make them stop.
Benevolence and safety.
It's our wedding day. I feel like all of
what do you need? May you return to her benevolence and safety.
Congratulations on your wedding. I'm so happy for both of you.
You sound good, yeah.
Yes.
Mara's domain encompasses the emotions we strive for. It's difficult to appreciate her gifts in these dark times.
But you should consider it a light, a beacon, a storm. It's our wedding day. I feel like all of Skyrim is focused on just the two of us. Congratulations on your wedding. I'm so happy for both of you.
I'm not running away. Just hoping to reset it a little. If I have to, I'll just load up the save. Because that was getting annoying. Though I still need a son. Okay. There he goes.
Let's begin the ceremony.
It was Mara that first gave birth to all creation, and pledged to watch over us as her children. It is from her love of us that we first learned to love one another. It is from this love we learned that life lived alone is no life at all. We gather here today under Mara's loving gaze to bear witness to the union of two souls in eternal companionship. May they journey forth together in this life and in the next, in prosperity and poverty, and in joy and hardship. Do you agree to be bound together in love, now and forever?
I do. Now and forever.
Do you agree to be bound together in love, now and forever?
Well, until she dies.
Under the authority of Mara, the divine of love, I declare this couple to be wed. I present the two of you with these matching rings, blessed by Mara's divine grace. May they protect each of you in your new life together.
We're married. I guess we'll need to decide where we're living, won't we?
Where are you?
You can always stay with me.
Where do you even live? I don't even know where you live. Okay, so I should have got a ring. What does the ring actually do? Ooh. I'll have to put it on, obviously, because, you know, that's what people do. I have two rings of smithing. I think one of them was for my daughter. Which means it won't leave my hand.
Disrespect the law and disrespect me.
She talked about wanting to choose where to live, but we never actually really talked about it.
Such a beast. Sadly, I have no sort of love of my own.
New in town, eh? Here for the fishing, I guess.
A nip in the air. Cold won't be good for my crops. Never is.
Hello. Did you bring me anything? I'd really like a dolly. Or maybe a pretty new dress? Wow, really? What do you get me? Mama took me to the market. There were lots of pies and cakes there. She said she'd show me how to bake one. Take care.
We're married. I guess we'll need to decide where we're living, won't we? You can always stay with me. Oh, but you have children, don't you? We'll have to find somewhere with room for them. Our new home. I'll see you there. It's a wonderful house, my love. If you don't mind, I'm going to start a small store. Something to do whenever you're on the road. Just fine. Whiterun is a lovely city, and there are so many other children here. They all love playing together. Some may call this junk. Me, I call them treasures. Goodbye, my love.
Late to be wandering around, isn't it?
Welcome to you. Take a look. May your road lead you to warm sand.
Hello, my love. Back from some adventure, I bet. My love, we have a cozy little prophet. Here, this is your share, love. Goodbye, my love. Thank you. Yes, my love? What do you mean?
Sure use a warm bed right about now.
Something? You tried mercenary work? It might suit you.
The Jarl is, as I'll be glad to help you. And of course, don't forget... Now, what would you like to purchase? Very well. Is there anything else you'd like to purchase? I'm sorry. Is there anything else you'd like to purchase? Enjoy your visit to Dragon's Reach.
I used to be an adventurer like you. Then I took an arrow from me.
I don't claim blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs. Don't forget to check inside the shop if you need anything.
Need something?
Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see. I've got a letter and a lot of gold. Something about it being your, inheritance. Oh, and sorry. Looks like that's it. Got to go. It's really dead then?
Got your back. I am sworn to carry your burdens. You lead, I'll follow.
Been a good friend to me. That means something. Too lazy to walk, eh? Well, you found the right place. Until next time.
Got your back. I am sworn to carry your burdens. Let's get going then. Got some good. I don't claim to be the best. Blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs. Don't forget to check. Inside the shop if you need anything.
It's no fun getting pushed around all the time.
Yes, my love? What do you need? We have a cozy little prophet. Here, this is your share, love. Just fine. Whiterun is a lovely city, and there are so many other children here. They all love playing together.
I work for Bellathor at the General Goods Store.
I'd be a lot warmer and a lot happier with a belly full of need.
What's the matter? You can't stand beside a strong Lord woman?
Come to chat with an old woman?
Papa, you're back! Let's play a game! What do you want to play? Okay, you're it.
You tried mercenary work?
Ha!
It might suit you.
Brave is a big meanie. She keeps telling Lars and me what to do. I don't want to play with her anymore. What is it? What is it? Thanks! What do you want to play? Stay safe. Did you need something, Papa? Bye, Papa.
Yes.
Still here. How can I serve you, my thane? to get going then.